Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes. A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Off to defeat the wanted monster, Gagagagagagagagagun. Sheep Highway! North is Capital Filden, east is the Ort Village, 415 milos. So 415 milos is from here to there. That's not a lot of milos. Well, milos is measured in feet, possibly inches. Anyway, we still can't see the map. So north is Filden, but what is this way? Oh, nothing. Well, there you go. Are we ready for a grand adventure? Defeat the wanted monster? I don't know if this is it. Our first monster, El Cargo, appeared. So it's like S Cargo, only it's an L Cargo. Check out that music. We got magic. Black magic fireball we can do twice. Let's save that. What about a skill? We can taunt it. Let's just fight it. What's deadly? Sonic sword. Oh, is this like a finishing move? It's mostly a finishing move. Instead of, they call it deadly. Okay. So he's got cure poison and this is... You can't see a description of it by pressing the side button, but... We'll attack it as well. Oh, that was easy. Win! Oh, we got a rare potion. Sweet. And 5 Pias. P-I-A. That's what that is. So now we got 5 Pias and 30 Roses. R-O-Z-A. And we got a lot of... If this is like the first one, I'm assuming it is, we can only have 10 of a single item. So we're almost full of the potions. Wait a second, where are we supposed to go? Oh wait. I already lost where we were. Okay, that's the town. Okay, that's a dead end. Okay. So we have to go this way. Let's go fight another one. We can go north and south from here. Oh, we got 2 L cargos. Happy pet. Feast the fence. We didn't even feed the thing. We didn't buy pet food. Let's focus on the same one. He's probably gonna one-shot it again. Miles says, 4 points, okay. Yeah! Okay, so if we go south... Oh, there's nothing. What about south from here? There's another thingy. What about north? There's no map available, so I'm just kinda winging it here. North is to the capital. Oh, we didn't one-shot at that time. Sweet. I like how he has this boomerang. Sweet. Very similar to the first. I'm assuming this is still towards the capital. Oh no, not really. It's a dead end. Okay, so we have to go south. Which is... this way, and then over... This is a dead end, right? Yeah. I'm gonna fight this one. I go north. So it doesn't... So the pet just comes randomly, not when you give it pet food. So what's the pet food for? Well, maybe when it gets hungry... Maybe it just does that randomly until it gets hungry. It's different from the way it worked in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Hey, don't you be hurt, my friend Mile. We still don't really need healing. We're pretty much okay. We will fight you. Just one. So I'll throw a save in case the difficulty ramps way up. Hi, we got a new enemy. A Kareem. Oh, I remember those egg things. Should we take out the Kareem or try to get... Let's get rid of the L cargoes first. Oh, 10 points. Okay, what we get left is the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar here. Oh wait, we've got full stuff. So let's use a sonic sword. And if that doesn't kill it, we'll do the flamethrow. Or one, or vice versa. Here I go, flamethrow. Oh, 163 points. Yeah, that did it. And another rare potion. We're starting to get full of them already. I'm gonna operate under the assumption that once you get to 10, you can't get any more. So I'm gonna use, instead of healing him with a spell, I'm gonna use a rare potion on him. Because we found a lot of them quickly. I don't think that's worth using the end move on it. Aven levels up. Oh, I like that sound. That sounded pretty cool. So Aven level 2. Mile as well. Mile was slow mastered. Is that a skill? No, it's a spell. Spell that slows the enemy's reflexes to reduce their ability to dodge. And I very rarely used those debuff and buffing spells in the first game. Who knows? It might be vital here. Oops. A voice says, Aya! Yaha! Wah! Somebody is shouting, says Aven. Who's that? What are you shouting at? Oh, he found the monster? There's a young man here. It says, Master Hamakages, you've got some nerve. How dare you throw me away like that? You'll see the wrath of Martie. Martie? What's he doing? Says Aven. I don't know. Martie says, oops. You're better than I thought. In honor of your mightiness, I shall cast my most powerful spell at you. Well, you sure have a funny way of talking to monsters. Let me see. How to kill shell monsters. He's looking through a book. Excuse me, says Aven. Don't talk to me. I'm busy now. The book is upside down. Oh, thanks. Yikes. Who are you? You surprised me. Okay, this is quite a character. I'm assuming he's gonna join our party as the comic relief. Even says, we're the ones who are surprised. What are you doing here? What do you mean, what am I doing here? My name is Marty. I'm an adventurer. I was sent to exterminate the monster. Monster? Do you mean... Miles says, the one wanted by the guild in the capital? Yeah, it's a violent monster called Hamakages. If you don't want to get hurt, stay away. Hamakages, I'll have no mercy on you this time. Is he really an adventurer? Says Avon. I think I'm much stronger than him. Oh no! For Pete's sake, not my spleen! Somebody help! It doesn't look good, Avon. I think he's in real trouble this time. Okay, let's go. Oh, there he is. Avon says, hey, are you alright? Of course I am. You two just stay away. Weren't you just screaming for help? It's too dangerous for kids. You look like a kid too. Well, then again, this is an anime kind of JRPG game, so everyone looks like kids except for the really old. Avon says, hey, shut up. You can't beat the monster yourself. Wow, what was that? Says Avon. This guy not only has enormous strength, but it can also use a powerful water spell. Oh yeah, those water balloon spells. I remember that from the previous game. Quick, get out of range of the spell. Avon says, unfortunately, we were also looking for this one. Mile says, Avon, it looks like we have no time to chat. Right, let's do it, Mile. Well, we got his finishing move. Big Hamakages appeared. Okay, he's joined our party. Sweet. Unfortunately, we can't fully check out what he can do, because we're in combat. Let's do the deadly sonic sword. And... we probably won't have to use it, because he's using his finishing move. Oh, steel throw? Oh, that's a... Oh, the slow is a magic spell. Yeah, let's try the steel throw. Let's see if we can steal from Hamakages. And then, whoever the hell this is, has got a fireball, stone blast, and dash. We can't hit the side button. I don't even know what it is. I think it's the square button to see what... In prophecy, you could do that. To get information. Well, let's throw a fireball at it. Why not? How about this? Sonic sword. This might just kill it, maybe? Nope, it's still alive. Aqua splash. Whoa. Aim here. What is it? Crimson fire, come to my palms to purify. Fireball. 29 points. Did we steal something from it? Oh, we stole a stimulant. Awesome. Unless this new party member had a stimulant on him already. Let's slow it. Reach out your earthly hands and hold them. Slow. What's that supposed to mean? Speed down. Ung. Well, we killed the Hamakages. However you say that. Silver anklet we got. Marty says, "Woo! You gave us a hard time. Thank you. You saved me. You two can fight, huh?" Avon says, well, Not really. I wish I could use a sword better, says Marty, not just spells. I'm a part-time adventurer. I'm actually a student. Have you heard of the minister's examination? Miles says, yeah, it's a very difficult exam. If you pass, you may become a minister someday. That's right. The minister's examination is just a nickname. Its official name is the Qualification Examination for Upper-Class Civil Servants. The purpose of the exam is to appoint the most talented persons regardless of their family's social standing or wealth. Anyone can take the exam, but you must study really hard to pass it. Haven says, so you're chasing monsters while studying? I don't think being an adventurer is that easy. Authorized by the Royal Family, the Adventurers Guild is a private association that protects the autonomy of each region. Unlike the King's Army, we don't have fixed salaries, and there are no rules. It doesn't matter if your weapon is a spell or sword. If you demonstrate that you have a certain level of fighting ability, you are qualified to be an adventurer. Really? So, do you think we're qualified? Take the exam at the Guild. I'm sure you will pass. Do you want to work as adventurers in the capital? Eamon says no, but having the status may help us during our journey. Miles says, actually, we are... Miles explained to Marty what had happened. Alright, says Marty. So, if you have proof that the wanted monster is dead, you have permission to travel, right? Then cut off a claw of Hamakages and take it back with you. That's how the members of the Adventurer Guild prove an accomplishment of their mission. Miles says, but then how do you prove you've killed Hamakages, Marty? Don't worry about me. I'll take the other claw. Here we go. This one is for you. The two were given Beast Claw. By the way, we should also share the bounty on this guy. They were given 50 rows. Nice. Are you sure? Eamon says. Don't you need a lot of roses as a student? I'll earn more. Besides, you two deserve some reward. I must go now. I hope to see you again in Capital Filden. I'm looking forward to visiting Capital Filden myself. Eamon says he was a strange guy, a part-time adventurer. But he did have a powerful spell, says Mile. I think he deserves credit. We should head back to the village, too. Miles says, we killed the monster. The elders will be surprised. Now, if you go this way, I bet you say no. Eamon, let's go back to the village. We killed the wanted monster. Alright, let's go back. I just gotta find my way back now. On this screen, it's a little... There's dead ends. I mean, we can navigate around them. I want to kill more of these things. We're level 2, baby! Yeah! So getting money. Nice. We have 80 roses and 80 Pias. Pias Agora. We want your money. We'll pull it out of your slimy butt. We need, like, leather armor and stuff. Ah! He tried to backstab you. Now, from here, I think we go, yeah, north. And we gotta go around. Let's fight this. Happy pet. Yay. I hope it has spells, too. Like, offensive spells. Those are pretty cool in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Thank you. I might grind a little just to get all the gear we need before we leave. So yeah, if you know how to play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, you know how to play this game. And ditto for Song of the Ocean, I'm sure. There's very minor differences. Interesting seeing them, though. Let me throw in a little bit to just make it more interesting. Okay, so here we are. Go back. Oh, they're all gathered here. Well, some of them. Half of them. Elder Rowan says, wait, Aven. Miles' father says, Mile. Aven says, shoot, they found us. What did you do? Says the elder. Why did you leave the village after I gave you a warning? All right. You're lucky to come back safely, but what were you going to do if you had counted the watered monster out there? What were we going to do? I wonder. Maybe kill it? Well, with help. As a matter of fact, Aven says, we did. What? I'm sorry, Elder, says Mile. I'm sorry, Mom, Dad, and Fam. Hey, Mile, Aven says. Don't say anything, Aven. I'm ready for my punishment, but please listen to what I have to say first. I'm sorry that we disobeyed you, but we just wanted to prove ourselves. Please take a look at this. Do you know what it is? Oh, I didn't look at the claw. Mile handed Beast Claw to Elder. I'm sure it didn't say anything that interesting. This is a claw of the monster? Yes, it's the claw of Hamakages, the monster wanted by the capital. It's a big claw, just as the warrant said. Miles' mother says, did you two defeat it? Fam says, they are heroes. Miles says, now the West Highway is safe. I believe we proved that we can protect ourselves as well as anyone. Will you allow us to go on a journey? Says the elder. Maybe you got a little lucky this time. However, the problem is that you broke your promise and left the village. You may not be so lucky next time and get really injured or do something that you can't fix. Forgive him, he's old. Enough, says Aven. You don't know very much for an old man. Oh boy. We are not little children anymore. We can make our own decisions. Stop, Aven, says Mile. Don't interrupt me, Mile. Mile says, it's not worth getting upset. They always treat me like a little child. Miles' father says, Aven, Mile! You guys want to go on a journey that bad? Yeah, says Mile. Aven says, I want to go no matter what it takes. Please, Dad, says Mile. Aven has a very important mission to accomplish. I'm not joking when I say that, either. And I want to get out of this village and see the world. I see. You're a man now. Dad? I also ran away from this village dreaming of becoming an adventurer when I was young. I traveled around many places in Elfilden without money or anything. Miles' father says, I'm sorry that I caused trouble to you, Elder. I remember that, says the Elder. I made lots of mistakes and had a bitter experience, but what I went through at that time has become my treasure now. I met your mom back then, too. Miles says, this is the first time you told me that. Miles' mother says, it's been almost 20 years. The father says, what do you think, Elder? They might make mistakes because of their youth, but they could also gain something from their mistakes. I'm sure this journey will become a treasure in their lives. Considering that, would you give them permission to go on a journey? The elder says, when I think of it, I also left on a journey for the same reason at a young age. The passion of the youth will never change. Aven says, then... Miles says, you are saying... The elder says, Aven, Mile, a journey is not all about fun and games. You will face unexpected difficulties and hardships. Will you promise that you will be strong at all times and come back here when you're done? Yes, says Aven. I promise, says Mile. Thus, Aven and Mile received permission to go on a journey. After eating the stew that Miles's mother cooked, they had a good night's sleep. Aven and Mile departed while the people were seeing them off. Did you forget anything? Miles's mother says. Do you have medicine? Hang your wallet from your neck. There must be bad people at the capital. Mom, you worry too much. We can't worry too much about this. Father says, honey, let's just stop here. But they're leaving for a journey, the father says. We shouldn't treat them like little children. Mile, take this with you. It has a cool sound, says Mile. This is called a guardian bell. Your grandpa gave this to me when I left for a journey. I was planning to give it to you when you became an adult. Well, he's 18, so he is an adult. Dad, a lot of deep thought was put into this bell. One who holds this must have compassion. Don't forget to be compassionate at all times. Look after your friends no matter what. Yes, I will. Help Aven accomplish his true purpose. Aven says thanks. Yuzu yells, Aven, Mile! Aven says, Yuzu, thanks. Everyone's gathering and waiting for you guys at the exit of the village. What's he thanking her for? Mile says, we better hurry. Let's go, Aven. Oh, they're not really hurrying. They're just walking normally. We're going back in to go get some provisions, though. Elder Rowan says, here you are, Aven, Mile. Sorry to have made you wait, says Mile. You better tell everybody goodbye. Aven says, well, everyone, we are now leaving on a journey. We're planning to go to the capital first to fulfill Lemuris's will. After that, we'll be traveling to Elfilden. I don't know when, but we will come back to Ort Village for sure. So until then, please take care of yourselves. Villagers are clapping. The elder says, it's springtime, so it's the perfect morning to begin your journey. I'm sure Mother Durga is watching over you. May Idun of Wind deliver you a pure breeze, and may Scotia of Water heal your fatigue. May Zar of Fire warm your cold body, and may Nephthys of Earth give you your daily food. Aven, Mile, take care of yourselves. Fam says, eat and sleep well. Come back with a lot of stories. Yuzu says, don't do anything stupid. I'm looking forward to hearing your adventures. You take care too, says Aven. Bye, everyone, says Mile. We have to get stuff. Let's just check around and see what Aven says. Elder's like, you're back already? Sage Dinerkin is one of the three great sages of Elfilden, just like Sir Lemuris. I hear he lives in Prayer Woods north of the capital, further down from Tibri Village. Be careful not to be rude to him. I was trying to remember something. Past the City of Coral? I forgot how it goes in Oblivion. Why would we be rude to him? That's a funny thing to say. Knowing you two, I knew it was only a matter of time before you would go on a trip. The village is too small for boys to stay in. That's why I am not going to stop you. Do your best. Mal says, Yuzu, thanks. Aven says, you take care too. Find yourself a man. Who's she got to choose from? Fam? The shopkeeper? I mean, they're older. I see, Aven. Do you want me to make your walk to the capital difficult? I'm sorry. It was only a joke. Come back a better person. You don't have to overwork yourself. Take one step at a time. Yeah, back as a better person doesn't make jokes like that. And the most important thing is... What? Says Aven. I expect you to bring me some souvenirs. Thank you. What does he have to say? I will miss you. Come back safely. Don't forget to cover up when you sleep. Beware of pickpockets. Make sure you boil the water. And what else? You worry too much, fam, says Avon. But thank you. And eat vegetables every day so you can keep from getting injured and ill. Miles says, I don't think I can avoid injury. Oh! Yay, we got that's mana restoring or magic point restoring potion there. Oh, nice! Another stimulant. I believe we bought a stimulant for 50 roses. Just checking on them. Miles' mother says, I won't say anything since they are gone. I will just pray for their safe return. But you're saying that to us. Father says, good luck, Avon. Mile, come back with a lot of stories. Alright. Finally in here. Also says, Avon, I'll give you this book as a goodbye present. Please read it when you have free time. Oh, we received Swordmaster 1. Nice. Books. Be sure not to waste your money, because it's going to be a long journey. But remember to buy necessary things regardless of expense. It's better to be safe than sorry. That's where we're going to buy a few things here. What's this book? Wartime novel popular around all ages, Volume 1, Ginkgo Round Dance. War Chronicles, Swordsmaster Zamza, Volume 1, Ginkgo Rondo. The time was year 247 in the Gagarv calendar. Golden leaves danced a rondo in the air, drifting to the ground. The man leaned against a large ginkgo tree with his eyes closed. Medium build, medium height, probably in his mid-20s. If he were walking in a crowd in the city, his handsome face would not go unnoticed by ladies walking by. The way his blonde hair drifted in the wind made him seem like a messenger from the large ginkgo tree. The skies were painted in the colors of dusk. The light was quickly fading away. The man was drifting in the memories of his beloved home, so far away. It's been a while since he left his home. Sir Zamza, I found you at last. A voice calling his name forced him back to the present, but his eyes remained closed. Rebel. Rebel? How are the soldiers? Sir, their morale is quite high as they emerged victorious in the last battle. I see. Have the 10 sages said anything about this battle with Sir Milligan? Yes, sir. About that. The 10 sages have decided to utilize the full force of the Red Tribe to fully resist and fight. An order to assume command of an army has already been here for you. Unbelievable. The members of the tribe are weary from the civil wars these past 40 years. It seems that there is no way we, the Red Tribe, have a chance. The man referred to as Zamza sighed. Although he is our enemy, Sir Milligan is an outstanding warrior and tactician. It seems like we're at a disadvantage. Perhaps the 10 sages have something in mind, he mumbled, his eyes narrowing. Our demise is at hand. What shall we do? We have no choice but to fight for now. We need to buy some time in any case. Let's retire for the evening. Rebel, you get some rest as well. Yes, sir, as you wish. After Rebel had left, Zamza put his hand on the sword at his side with his eyes closed. Suddenly, he opened his eyes and his battle arm flashed in motion. The large ginkgo tree fell to the ground with its treetop seemingly wiping the skies clean. Those old men seemed to ask the impossible. Zamza glared at the heavens in frustration. I see. I'm sure we'll find more volumes of that. And finally, let's exchange. Ooh! We got a lot of money. Nice! Alright, so I do want to get one of those. Rebelief. Mile can use this, a wooden shield. Martie Mile and Avon can use this. Leather armor. And leather boots are 140. We can't just afford that. It'll help with speed. And pet food. Let's buy one of that. Dried pet food, one of that. Soft pet food. One of that. And crunchy pet food. Oh, we don't have enough of that. Alright, so believe it or not, I'm gonna do a little grinding before we leave here, because I want to get one of the crunchy pet food. I'm gonna get leather boots for both of them. I don't know how many peers we need for that. Oh, then again, we haven't sold our cloth armor, so let's put this stuff on first. Wooden shield. Mile goes from defense 21 to 23. It's better than nothing. Oh, I'm gonna go out. Alright, I didn't see what this is. Silver anklet. Helps magic defense. From 18 to 22. Can we get a description of that? Protector. Armor made by of animal hide. Lighter and faster than metal armor. This is accessory. Amulet made of silver, known as the holy metal. Protects against spells. Alright. Who's got the least magic defense, then? 18 to 22, or... Yeah, he's got better, so... Let's help Avon with that. Put that on. And we don't have any other... Oh, we have two silver anklets? Oh, wow. Alright. Well, let's give Mile one. I didn't realize we had two. Mile will go from 23 to 27. Cool. Alright. So we're gonna switch the cloth armor for the leather. Going from 24 to 26. And same here. 23 to 25. Now let's sell these cloth armors. $80. Still not enough. I can buy the crunchy pet food. I'm not gonna get the blaze charm. I know that's something you can use over and over again. Because it says it's a talisman, but it's got the icon like as if it's a potion. I tend to think it's something that has like charges on it. Let's get a re-belief. Just one, obviously. Alright, so I want to come back here. I want to go fight these snails. And, come back to get them both the leather boots. Which are 140 roses each. Alright, so... I don't know, I might cut that out. Just gonna fight a bunch of snails. Before we leave here. So there'll be a better speed, right? So anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.